Hi, my name is Ruth Awolola. It's my absolute privilege to have been chosen by the Poetry Society and the T.S. Eliot Prize to review Zaffar Kunial's fantastic collection, England's Green, which has been shortlisted for the T.S. Eliot Prize 2022. England's Green is split up into two parts, part one in and part two out, throughout which Kunial elegantly and effortlessly interweaves and explores a wide variety of themes, including but not limited to family, fantasy and flowers, literature, loss, and a love for cricket. Through the poems, which are presented in a range of poetic forms, we explore Kunial's relationships to his parents, to his grandparents, to his son, but also to the world, to England, to the places he grew up, to the snowdrops, hawthorns, forget-me-nots, and foxgloves he passed on his walks during lockdown. England's Green is a collection that will transport you, as Kunial maps out personal locations of significance. Several of the poems explore his upbringing in Birmingham, with Kunial often referencing exact locations with street names. At the end of Birchcliff Road comes Birch Place, which for the nth time I read as birthplace, he writes in the poem Pressings. There are references to the places and the counties that surround Birmingham as well. Boddenham in Herefordshire, Bascote Heath in Warwickshire. In the poem Oh, we learn about his great-great-grandfather changing his Irish surname and moving to Aberdeen. The poem Scarborough transverses numerous locations Kunial associates with his mother, including the coast of Rhyl in North Wales, which is both a holiday destination for her in her youth and the location she was heading to when she met Kunial's father in Birmingham. Kunial is currently based in Hebden Bridge, and the poetry about the north of England is among some of my favourites. His explicit descriptions and use of personification create vivid imagery, perhaps best exemplified in Bronte's Taxis. The whole village clings to the hill, he writes in the first stanza. The steep B&Bs, their hinged signs lifting in the breeze, grip the tipping verticals of Haworth, he concludes in a second. What absolutely beautiful imagery. Another striking thing about this collection is Kunial's ability to examine both the massive and the minute. He explores the existential concept of time, which features throughout the collection, looking at Kunial's personal and family history, as well as the history of England. But he simultaneously considers the small things, from the recurring motif of butterflies and flowers to mentions of atoms and cells. The poem, The Nonsense of Observing Outer Space, is a great example of this, with a poem about an individual butterfly and the dense and nascent universe. Perhaps for me, one of the most exciting and distinctive aspects of Kunial's work is his ability to take a word and look at it as if under a microscope, dissect it, isolate and examine the sounds within a way that completely reframes your understanding of the word. As shown with the word foxglove in Foxglove Country and the word Himalaya in Foregrounds. Words have pockets. Small, deep pockets that go on for ages, states Kunial in the poem Little Books. And the poems in this collection are a testament to that. Thirdly, this is a collection that concerns itself with literature. Thorned blank verse, strange runes, folio text, writes Kunial in The Hedge. Kunial is paying homage to and drawing influence from eminent poets, playwrights and authors that have gone before him, with references to Sylvia Plath's grave, a street where Tolkien lived, a quote from Ted Hughes, epigraphs quoting the likes of T.S. Eliot, Shakespeare, Iris Murdoch and Edward Lear, a poem written in response to the Spanish poet Juan Ramon Jimenez, and the poems Little Books and The Wind in the Willows are concerned with children's literature. Kunial's fondness for the Bronte sisters is also apparent, not just in Bronte's Taxis, but the poem Scarborough is written to Anne Bronte, the newly bred rose to Emily Bronte. And in the first stanza of Little Books, Kunial adopts the voice of Patrick Bronte, addressing his daughter Charlotte Bronte. Not only is England's Green a pleasure to read, it encourages you to continue reading and illustrates beautifully how great literature leads to the production of more great literature. Kunial's passion for cricket is evident throughout the collection. He uses it to explore many of the other themes, including family and time. But the example that particularly resonates with me is when he compares it to another of his big passions, writing, in The Oval Window, writing, Walking out in the middle, there is a growing distance, as the crowd is further away, even loneliness, but an intense presence surrounding you. This is what it can feel like writing alone. I wholeheartedly encourage you to go out and grab yourself a copy of this collection if you haven't done so already. It's one I know I will be returning to again and again. If you want to find out more about England's Green, the T.S. Eliot Prize, or the Poetry Society's work with young people, please follow the links in the description below. Thank you very much for watching.